The first question that competitors at a concrete canoe competition must answer is, will it float? At the 2007 American Society of Civil Engineers Regatta held at Purdue University, only Bradley University failed the test. The team turned to an engineer's best friend, duct tape, to attach life vests for additional flotation.
It'll be able to handle a couple people. As long as it doesn't go underwater, it should be able to stay afloat. So we're going to throw in the two lightest people we have, and it'll do just fine.
Purdue and other teams each spent several hundred hours designing and building their thin concrete hulls that are strengthened by rebar, mesh, or in Purdue's case, wispy black carbon fibers.
Taking this one out, I was pleasantly surprised. It handled a lot like the fiberglass canoe, so all three of us girls were very excited that it wasn't too much heavier than we expected, so it went pretty well.
The University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign turned in a second place finish overall with a well-designed, if low-riding, entry.
We calculate how high it's going to ride in the water, so we're not too concerned. It's not going to sink. That's why we had the swamp test. We know it can handle it. We do worry about water coming in over the sides. Last year, for example, our boat kind of tipped forward, and so in these races, it was filling up from the front, and we had to worry about that.
The University of Wisconsin national champs 4 years running swept the Great Lakes Regionals once again. Wisconsin won first place for their design, but distanced themselves even further on the water by paying attention to the human element.
It's all year round. We're paddling up and down the river during the fall. Middle of winter, we'll go out and keep paddling. It doesn't matter how cold it is, we're out there practicing. And we also like to practice with some of marathon canoers, and it sort of pushes us to go farther than we would push ourselves.
Cross-state rivals Marquette never had a chance, falling victim to a bumpy ride down I-65 that broke their canoe in half.
Today, since it's cold beyond belief, it's kind of nice that we don't have to get in the water, but our team members, since they worked on it for months, it's kind of disappointing they couldn't see it actually, see if it worked or floated. So we're kind of let down on that factor, but it's nice not getting in the cold water.
While Marquette huddled under the blankets, paddlers from Bradley and Southern Indiana both ended up in the drink. A spirited Valparaiso University team managed to keep its cracked canoe afloat, with bailing cup ever close at hand.